All right. So we have call time today. I want to definitely do some booster draft, but I wanted to try out this kind of brew that I started kind of touching on during the early access event, but fleshed out a little bit more carefully my ideas. I'm excited about this card, Waking the Trolls, in a ramp deck. First of all, the extra land that it gives you does matter if you're trying to ramp to larger things like Genesis Ultimatum or Ugin or, scalable spells like Shark Typhoon. That all adds up. And then Waking the Trolls is kind of nice because it's like very effective against mid-range and control because taking away their mana is important. But if you play against aggro where you're less excited about the destroy target land part, that probably means that you're going to make more trolls, and those trolls are going to lead to winning the game more easily. So it's like this card has three modes that are all highly useful in different matchups and situations, and I've been liking it. It's also a permanent, so you can play a Genesis Ultimatum in a deck where, yeah, I have 56 permanents, other than Cultivate, every single card hits the battlefield off of the Genesis. Well, excuse me, 52 permanents because Genesis Ultimatum itself is not one, but anything other than Cultivate and Genesis Ultimatum is hitting the battlefield. Enigma, thanks for the sub. So, all right, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna commit to five matches on the ladder with this Temur Ultimatum Waking the Trolls deck, Temur Trolls, as I've named it. After that, if you want to stick around for the stream, I'll probably move to booster draft. But I'm also gonna record this as a video for CFB, which means I do want to give a shout out to my sponsors. If you sign up for CFB Pro, do any business with Channel Fireball, you can use my affiliate code Reid, Reid. I do appreciate that. I also want to point you to a couple of cool promotions that we have going on in January and February. They're related to Kaldheim release. The first is the release party. We're bringing the pre-release experience to your home. This is a place for folks to hang out, crack booster packs, get advice on sealed decks, play games via spell table, and more. Channel Fireball is selling kits for the release party, but you don't have to buy a kit. Anyone who has their own Kaldheim packs is welcome to join. That's hosted on the Channel Fireball Discord on February 6th. So be sure to check out that Discord. We also have Box Breaks, a group. Box Break is a fun and exciting way to buy trading cards. You and a group of other collectors split a box of cards by purchasing different groups of cards. Box is going to be opened live on stream, and then you receive all of the non-common cards opened from your group. So if you want more information about that stuff, check out the Channel Fireball website. And if you are opening some Kaldheim packs, you're going to need to store your cards, which is where I'd point you towards Ultimate Guard. Store and sleeve your cards, the Katana sleeves, the Archive, the Sidewinder deck box. Just browse the Ultimate Guard catalog online to see if anything is a good fit for you. All right, thanks for listening. And five matches on the ladder, Temur Trolls. Hallelujah in the chat says there's a four mana sorcery that destroys lands. Did you consider that? Can you refresh my memory on exactly what that card does? Four mana is a little bit tough because I'm not even playing Solemn Simulacrum, which is a good card and could easily be in this deck. I also had various other brews that involved binding the old gods, which is a card that's great in a ramp deck. I even have a four-color brew that uses Genesis Ultimatum and touches into black for that. But yeah, point being, four mana is a tough spot on the curve. But always open to the suggestions. Am I planning on brewing any decks with the new Tybalt? Yeah, for sure. I saw somebody had good success with that in Historic, in the Rakdos Luris Arcanist deck. Tybalt's pretty nice. Rothmiss Prime says they went down a YouTube rabbit hole watching my old legacy matches from 6 years ago. I think that's a fine thing to do. Had some good games back then. That's probably Miracles era. Yeah. All right. I don't even know if my opponent is here and wants to play with me. I guess I'll keep this hand just. Not super exciting, but three lands and a Beanstalk Giant should set me up well. Okay, thanks for the card. It's called Smashing Success. Four mana instant. Destroy target artifact or land. And if you destroy an artifact, create a treasure token. Interesting. If I could destroy the land and get the treasure token, I might be into that either main deck or sideboard. Because it's like you can kind of just. Reminds me of that card, that old card, Wanvuli Acid Moss, where you destroy their land and get a land for yourself. Just kind of like catapulting ahead on mana is really nice. But I think if I'm not destroying too many artifacts, that's probably not where I want to be. So by the way, I committed to five matches. If my opponent never plays a card here, that's not going to count. That's we'll go right to match number two. Where would I play Vorinclex in standard? Well, for starters, any deck with Castle Garenbrig, that's a really nice pairing. I also played a little bit with Elves, where, first of all, Elves are capable of generating a lot of mana, right? So you can just play a 6/6 for 6 and be kind of happy with that. But also, if you can double the counters on Tyvar Kell, you can ultimate really quickly, and that generally leads to a win. So I don't know. I think Vorinclex is just a good standalone card and kind of any. Heavy green deck you'll be excited about. Okay, interesting. Do I want to keep an all mana hand? My answer is yes. Having mana and early plays in a deck like this is way massively more important than having your payoff because you have only a very small number of draw steps to find your Wolf Willow Haven or your Cultivate, but you have the whole game to find your Genesis Ultimatum. As it turns out, I found Ultimatum. I'm gonna have to play one of these lands as a green source, which means I'm one colored mana away from the Ultimatum. But yeah, so far so good, I would say. I'm playing Snowlands because I have Frostbite in my sideboard. Well, I mean, that works, I guess. That's a fine card to draw, but I also painted myself into a corner here with my red mana situation, so I won't be able to play that next turn. But sure. Should I make a wolf right away? Or wait? I think I'll make a wolf right away. Could just block, but I think that's probably not the ideal move. Well, let's see. If I take it, I go to 11. If they Kroxa, I go to 8. Then the Kroxa is basically, well, all right, sure, I'll take it. No blocks. I have the Wolf Willowhaven. If I draw even like a Lotus Cobra, I could kill something. Now I probably have to block and trade off. Remember, the Croax is coming next turn. Probably want to just save the Cultivate to discard it. I think I'll try double block. My opponent's just trying to fill their graveyard slash empty their hands because they have to use Castle Lochtwain and get back to Kroxa. Sure. I think I can grab an island here. Coma Cosmos Serpent, that's a great idea. It's a uncounterable threat. That could be really good. Well, it's actually lethal if my opponent has nothing. Wow. I thought I was for sure, or not for sure, but I thought I was going to lose this game basically unless I drew Genesis Ultimatum. But after double blocking the Croak, said they didn't really have any more pressure, so I was able to just top deck out of it. I guess I'll just sideboard more for the top deck battle, like Lotus Cobra, Bone Crusher Giant. My opponent's often just going to have removal for them. Maybe Terror of the Peaks is a little weaker. I don't know. Interesting. Maybe I want to do something more like this. But I like having the Shark Typhoons and the Ugin, because if I get Thought Seized a couple times and I just have to top deck something, I want that density of powerful cards. Indatha Triome, that's interesting. I thought this was just a Rakdos deck. Wait, is this just me, or does this seem like a completely different deck than I faced in the first game? Poldo in the chat is a fan of Vintage Cube Draft. Yeah, Vintage Cube is not available on Magic Online at all times of year, but I usually play some every time it comes available. So you'll see that again in the future. Okay. All the Shark Typhoons, that's good. I think probably my safest move is just to Shatter Skull smashing these two creatures. I imagine I'm not really going to lose once the chapter 3 goes off. Okay, four trolls, please. Four trolls coming right up. I played Jund Trolls on Wednesday, a couple days ago. I think Rogues is still a great deck. Yeah, you can see I'm preparing for Rogues in my sideboard still with the Chainweb Arachnirs. Okay, opponent reveals Yorion. I think I just want mana, given that I already have Genesis Ultimatum in hand. Looks like there's a couple different ways I could do this. Oh, actually, that doesn't work because. There's a couple different ways I could do this, and I picked the one that doesn't work because I don't want to actually search for a basic forest with my Fabled Passage. So, what should I have done? Cobra, Fabled Passage, crack it, Beanstalk Giant. But either way, I wouldn't have a guaranteed ultimatum because I would have five lands and a Cobra with only a enters the battlefield tapped land in my hand. Plus the Cobra, you know, somewhat likely to die or get Skyclave Apparition, something like that. Oh boy. Alright. I didn't even have to cast the second ultimatum. Ooh, okay. I think I'll not attack into a possible shark. Because with the Cobra on the battlefield, I'm one land drop away from casting my top end cards. Sure. Ouch. Okay. could make a wolf. I could cycle now, or I could pass with cycling mana available. I think I'd like to make a wolf. Although if that was my plan, I shouldn't have bounced the Triome. I should have bounced an untapped land. No, I think I'm just gonna pass. Because if I make a wolf and then my opponent sweeps the board like this, then I can't untap and play Ugin. So currently 8 mana. If I tap 2, play the Cobra, then I have 6, then the Triome. I can make colored mana and play the Ultimatum. There is some concern about Mystical Dispute. However, the Ultimatum's like massively more powerful to resolve than the Ugin is. Because it's hard for me to minus against when I have these Wolf Willow Havens. And if I just Ugin and plus, then I'm kind of vulnerable to Elspeth Conqueror's Death or anything along those lines. I think I'm going to make the high upside play of going for a Ultimatum. I think it's probably 50-50 if I get disputed here. All right, I didn't get disputed. Oops, meant to bounce the Triome. I should have another opportunity to do that, though. So if I had just gone for the Ugin play, I'm probably in a kind of tough spot against the Elspeth Conqueror's Death, so I don't mind the way that played out. So I'm starting with 9, 10, 11 mana. Think I should just Ugin and minus 5. I mean, what, I could cycle a Triome first. Maybe Ugin and plus is also okay. Thank you. All right, opponent has seen enough. I guess they couldn't answer the Ugin. A Colt says, wasn't that last play risky against a possible Yorian? Yes, but if I minus five, I lose my three Wolf Willow Havens and my Lotus Cobra. So I'm not even necessarily in a winning position if I do the minus five play. But you're absolutely right. It is risky. Foretell. Well, we're setting up. I think I'm just going to cast this. Oh, no. I thought I clicked on the Shatter Skull Smashing. Not that it's a big deal. I mean, it's the end result's going to be minus three life, but I was trying to play Shatter Skull Smashing tapped. Uh-oh, Scry top. That's not necessarily a great sign. My opponent's surely got some counter spells ready for me, but I can just play three ultimatums on back-to-back-to-back turns. Wow, I didn't expect that to resolve. Not bad. Well, I think I'm trying again. Okay, that time they saw it coming. Three, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. I don't know about all this bouncing the Bone Crusher Giant stuff that my opponent is doing. Okay, opponent doesn't want to play anymore. I kept an all mana hand last time. I think this one's even more reasonable. Or I kept an all mana hand earlier in the stream. I think this one is fine also because it has the Triome and the Shatterskull Smashing. Hmm. I actually think it might be a good idea just Shatter Skull smashing that mammoth right now. Buy me a lot of time, keep the Great Henge off the battlefield. Because if I play the dragon, my opponent's just going to play a land and attack me, and it's like already a stressful situation if I want to trade or not. But I think this play prolongs the game, and my hand is really strong in a long game. Or I should say my deck is really strong in a long game. Well, it looks like I'm going to need a big hit off of the Genesis Ultimatum. If I just hit, like, you know, four lands and a Cultivate, I'm going to be dead. If I hit some Lotus Cobras, I might be able to cast a second ultimatum. Just barely not dead on board. If I block the wolf, take 7 down to 1. Yep, that'll do it. So that's, I guess, an important to note the weakness of an exciting new card, but you know, Waking the Trolls, if you get killed the turn you play it, that, you know, it doesn't really help you in that window of time. Thank you. Try like that. So I could either go Cobra, Cobra, or I could play Cultivate. If you go Cobra, Cobra, then if I draw an untapped land, I have Ultimatum. Or Beanstalk Giant's free, and then Cultivate gets me up to 6 mana. If I cultivate 3, 4, 5. I think the Cobra is higher upside. Oh boy. Terminator, thanks for that cheer. Destroy your forest, please and thank you. Okay. All right, another all mana hand, but actually this is a matchup where just casting Beanstalk Giant can sometimes do a lot. So I'm gonna go to 15. Then I could easily envision taking like 13 next turn. I probably won't actually die though. I wonder if I should just play Terror of the Peaks. Just try to curve Terror into Beanstalk Giant rather than play Waking the Trolls, take a massive hit. Salat says, may I ask why you're trying Waking the Trolls? I feel like the first two chapters are not that useful. Well, I guess that's where we disagree. I think the first two chapters do a lot in a lot of subtle ways. That's what I didn't want to see. Probably just dead now. Unless I find that, that changes the equation. All right. Could wind up being an interesting game. We know my opponent has a non-land card in hand. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11. So wake the trolls and make a wolf. Then the name of the game is just try to hang on until chapter three comes off. Oh yeah, good point that I can actually rebuy the Crawling Baron's additional blocker. This, I'm not quite dead, but it's super close. Oh no, does this double counters? That if this doubles counters on the wolves, then I think I am dead. Man, such a close match. Such a close match. Well, I hope Lotus Cobra survives. Probably not surviving against a Orzhov player.
sounds here.
All right, we have one or two trolls coming. Sorry, two or three, right? Yeah, two or three trolls coming. Oh boy. Love it when a plan works out. Let's see. I don't want to cast the Bone Crusher, right? Whenever an opponent sacrifices a non-token permanent or discards, may put that card onto the battlefield under your control. Okay. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10 mana. All right, so I want to have lots of late game staying power. And I also want to have lots of ways to kill Valky. Probably just like this. Yes, I have an exclamation point in my stream title so that you know that you should be excited. Kaldheim! GG's last round tour guide. Thanks for stopping by the stream.
might spare your life.
How bad is it if I give this Orzhov player a Shark Typhoon? Probably pretty bad. But I might do it anyway. All right, here's a Shark Typhoon for you.
You think too much. Some attention I don't love. Keep your grimy.
Does this have menace? Okay, big draw step for the opponent here. Can you get the ultimatum out of my hand? No, you cannot. Okay, what have we here? Sacrifice a non-land permanent or discard a card. Okay, so I can discard Cultivate. The three life here.